Thank you for joining us today. I'm Antti Nurmi. I'm Charles Rivers, Managing Director for Charles Rivers Discovery Finland, and I'm here at the Society for Neuroscience meeting in Washington, D.C. I'm here today with Gunnar Flick, Site Director for Brains Online, which is now part of Charles Rivers. And we are talking about today about Brains Online operations and their activities in neuroscience. Welcome, Gunnar, to the today's discussion. One of the core strengths of Brains Online has been, of course, the use of microdialysis in experiments. So, why is it important to use microdialysis in live animals?
So you're measuring the freely moving animals. So you have the whole organism where you're measuring. With microdialysis, you can sample from the brain. And with these samples, you can measure multiple transmitters. So if you have a compound and you want to profile your compound, microdialysis is a tool where you can measure different neurotransmitters, but also you can measure the compound concentration in brain. So you can see the effect of your compound on different transmitters and also see what doses will give you that effect.
And so what are the things that we can learn about it? So we can look at neurotransmitter levels, we can look at drug concentrations in the brain while the animals are freely moving and even behaving in the behavioral tasks.
Correct,
and so on. So how about then monitoring large molecules like antibodies, larger molecules like amyloid and things like that? So do you do those kind of studies as well?
Yeah, so we started out first with small molecules, but now the field is changing. Alzheimer's and Parkinson's disease, where you see that large molecules are very important. Mm-hmm. We have a special technique called push-pull microdialysis. With this technique, we can also sample large molecules. And with that, we can also sample the antibody. So you can see whether your antibody crosses the blood-brain barrier, which is important, and then also see the effect of your antibody in brain. Simultaneously, we can have a jugular vein catheter, so we can measure your antibody in blood, but also in the CSF. So we have three compartments we can measure at the same time from the same animal. So you can see the PK relationship, PK-PD relationship between in the animals between different compartments.
Are there any methodologies that would be kind of equivalent or similar to microdialysis, but there are kind of new evolving or emerging technologies? Do you have any insight to this?
So, of course, we're working on different techniques to see whether we can use that for, like, sensors. So we're working on sensors. Your resolution with the sensor is higher, so you can see fast effects with the sensor. And the disadvantage of the sensor is that you can only sample or analyze one analyte. With microdialysis, you do multiple analytes. So I think it's not replacing microdialysis, but it will be a nice method to put next to microdialysis.
Yeah. Do you see any major breakthroughs potentially coming in the next coming years, or anything that you consider that might be very valuable or important from neuroscience perspective?
So I think with the new research and with working with antibodies, I think there's a new field. Mm-hmm. And with this new technique, with push-pull, I think we can help out exploring whether these antibodies will be a drug in the end.
Yeah.
So I think there's a much to gain.
Wonderful, wonderful. Well, thank you. Thank you very much for this interview.
Thank you.
Thank you all for today's discussion, joining us.